Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to discuss genetic code. What is genetic code? Genetic code is a set of rules by which information encoded within the genetic material is actually translated into the proteins by the living cells. It means what are the information hidden inside the mRNA in the form of the nucleotides? It is get translated into the amino acids and then finally into the proteins. And this is a type of decoding. It means the nucleotide information in the nucleotide is decoded into the amino acids. And this biological decoding is accomplished in the ribosomes, in which the tRNA will carry an amino acid specified by the mRNA, and it will read the mRNA three nucleotides at a time. And these three nucleotides are known as the codon or one genetic code. There are so many discovery was done regarding the genetic code. Like George Gamow, he postulated that three letter code must be employed to encode the 20 amino acids which are used by the living cells to build any protein. Any protein present inside our body is made up of only 20 amino acids. Out of these 20 amino acids, 10 are essential, 10 are non-essential amino acids. Okay, and these 20 amino acids only will produce all the proteins. So he said that the three letter code must be employed. It means what actually happened, the tRNA having two sites. One is amino acid carrying site, one is the anticodon site. This anticodon site will read the three nucleotide code on the mRNA. Okay, so always the tRNA synthesizes 4 to the power n number of amino acids by reading the mRNA. Why 4? Because we are having 4 nucleotides, ATGC. Okay, so if tRNA will read 2 nucleotides at a time, it means there will be 4 to the power 2, only 16 amino acids will be formed. But that's not enough, because our body needs at least 20 amino acids. If the tRNA will read 4 nucleotide at a time, then 4 into 4 into 4 into 4, there too much of amino acids will be produced. Okay, so what happened actually, the tRNA reads the minimum 3 nucleotide at a time and 64 amino acids will be produced. But as our body is synthesized having only 20 amino acids, so these all combinations, like 64 combinations, will produce the 20 amino acids. Okay, now some of the experiment was done by Crick Banner, Nirenberg and Matthew. What they have done, actually they decode some of the amino acids by using some chain of the nucleotides. Like they performed the translation of a polyuracil chain, RNA chain, and they found that only phenylalanine amino acid was synthesized. Like that, several work has been done. Some subsequent work was also done by Dr. Hargobind Khurana sir, who identified the rest of the genetic code. Now we will see the property of the genetic code. There is some properties of the genetic code. The first property is it is composed of a nucleotide triplet, like we have already discussed. Next is the genetic code is non-overlapping. Always you will find that there will be no overlapping between two codes or two codons. The genetic code is comma free. There will be no comma between the two codes. The genetic codon is degenerative. What does it mean? Degenerative means the more than one genetic codon can code for a same amino acid. Okay, like 4 or 3 different codons can encode a same amino acid. The next is genetic code is ordered. Always there will be an order in the genetic code. The genetic code contains start and stop codons. Like AUG is the start codon. Okay, UAG, UGA, these are all the stop codons. The genetic code is also universal. What does it mean? It means all the living cells will synthesize the same amino acid by reading the same genetic code. Yeah, some exceptions are there that we will discuss later. Now, what are some salient features of the codon? The first is the reading frame. If we will, if I will tell you that we are having one sequence G G G A A A and C C C, and if we will found that which amino acid this mRNA will encode, so if we will read from the first position, then we will get three codon G G A A A A and C C C. But if we start from the second position, we'll have some other codons like G G A. AAC, two codons. If we will start from the third position, we will have GAA and ACC. So it means if we, the start positions matters and it defines, governs that which amino acids are going to be synthesized. It means from a single strand, there are three different frames which produce the different amino acid sequences. Similarly, if you are having double strand, it means you will have these six different frames. Okay, three frame on forward strand, three frame on the reverse strand. But what is the actual frame? This actual frame is governed, defined by the start codon. If the start codon is present on the second frame, it means this will be our actual protein, actual amino acid sequence. Yeah, start and stop codon, AUG, as I told you, the start codon which code for methionine, UAG, UAA and UGA, these all are the chain termination or terminator codons. Next is the degenerative code or ordered code. Like what degenerative means, the occurrence of more than one codon per amino acid is called degeneration. Means like three amino acid, leucine, serine and arginine. Okay, see, we are having this entire chart. Okay, so in this chart, the three amino acids, leucine, serine and arginine. See, it's leucine, serine, okay, and arginine. Where is arginine? The arginine. Okay, you can see that leucine is encoded by four different codons. See, two here, four here. Leucine encoded by six different codons. Serine is also encoded by six different codons. Four here, two here. Arginine is also encoded by six different codons. Four here and two here. Okay, these are some points to be remembered. We cannot remember the entire table, but these are the points which we can remember. So three amino acids, leucine, serine and arginine, each specified by six different codons. Actually, this amino acid is not the right word. Six different codons. Okay. Now, the next is methionine and tryptophan. Just remember, methionine and tryptophan are the only amino acid which is encoded by a single codon. Okay, see. Where is tryptophan? This is like AUG for methionine and this UGG for tryptophan. So tryptophan and methionine are the only amino acid which is encoded by a single codon. It means there is no degeneracy in these two amino acids. Okay, and rest of the amino acids, some are coded by four, some are coded by two, like that only. So these two things we need to remember about serine, arginine and serine, arginine and leucine, and about methionine and tryptophan. So actually there are two type of degeneracy. First is a partial degeneracy, second is a complete degeneracy. What is partial degeneracy? If we will change the third position from purine to pyrimidine or pyrimidine to purine, the amino acid will change, like here. Here you can see UUC, it is encoding for the phenylalanine. But if the third position C, which is actually a pyrimidine, if the C change by A, which is purine, or G, which is also purine. If the C is changed by, it means the pyrimidine is changed by the purine, the amino acid changes. Okay, this phenylalanine now changed to leucine. This is known as the partial degeneracy. Then what is complete degeneracy? If any of four bases present at the third position in the codon will still specify the same amino acid. And here one example is valine. Here you can see. Example of valine. This GU, GU, GU. All second positions are same for all the four codons. And at the third position, this UC CAG. We are having these four nucleotide only. So at the third position, all the nucleotides are occur, but in all the cases, it is actually encoding the same amino acid. This is one of the examples. Some more examples are there. Okay, so this I just want to explain you what is complete degeneracy and what is partial degeneracy. Complete degeneracy means any nucleotide is present at the fourth position, it will still encode the same amino acid. Partial degeneracy means if at third position purine is changed to pyrimidine or vice versa, then the amino acid is changed. Okay, the next property, genetic code is universal. It means the same code is used by all living organism, prokaryotes or eukaryotes. Yeah, but some few exceptions are there, and these exceptions are mainly found in the mitochondrial gene. As you know that our mitochondria having its own genome and it is also get translated. So what is the difference? Like UGA. UGA is a stop codon for all the eukaryotic and prokaryotic cell. But in case of mitochondria genome, UGA is not a stop codon. It will encode the tryptophan amino acid. So this is an exception. Another exception, like most of the animal mitochondria, they use AUA for methionine, not for isoleucine. Cytosolic genome, this AUA code for isoleucine, but the mitochondrial genome code AUA into methionine. Okay, and what are the stop codons in mitochondria? AGA and AGG are the stop codons or the chain terminators. Okay, and one more exception is there. Each mitochondria assign all codon beginning to CU to threonine instead of leucine, like CU. Okay, C. Where is CU? Yeah, CU. In our cases, or in the case of cytoplasmic genome, any codon start with CU, it will code for leucine. But in case of mitochondria, it will code for threonine, not for leucine. Okay. So that's all about the genetic code. Okay, thank you.